1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 5, 1, 2, 3, 6, 1, 2, 3, 7, 1, 2, 3, 8, 1, 2, 3, 9, 1, 2, and 10. One. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Chicken, what are you doing? Do you have any idea what a jumping jack is? I said jumping jack, not jumping joker, chicken. Now get to your side. Get over there with your feet together. Put your wings to your side. All right? Now I want you to put your arms up over your head and put your hands together like that. And as you do that, I want you to put your feet about shoulder length apart. All right, now do it the other way. Chicken, you dumb cluck, get around here the way I am. Now put them back down to your sides, what I mean, as you put your feet together. Ready? Go on. Now keep doing it. All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. You got it, chicken. Wait, chicken. You're supposed to do it in place, chicken. Chicken!
Now that's the silliest thing I have ever seen.
What in the world? What's the matter with you? Chicken looks sick.
Hey, you guys. Look who our five-footed friend has bumped into. It's Tom Seaver.
Yay!
Hi, chicken.
Hi,
all right, we finally see a familiar uniform. You know, Bunch, Tom is one of the finest right-handers of the modern era.
In 1967, Tom Seaver was the National League's Rookie of the Year. And 2 years later, he led the Miracle Mets to a World Series championship. 3 times he's won the Cy Young Award as the National League's best pitcher. And let me tell you, Bunch, it's not much fun trying to hit a Tom Seaver fastball. So I was thrilled when he became a teammate of mine in 1977. Cincinnati, Seaver continued his winning way, and I learned from close up why they call him Tom Terrific. Then in 1980, Seaver threw a fastball by Keith Hernandez for strikeout number 3,000. When he finishes his career, it'll be straight to the Hall of Fame for Tom Seaver.
Well, thanks, John, but I'm really not ready to retire yet. You know, I'm only 36 years old, and one of the reasons that I do these exercises, so I'll be able to do what I really love to do, and that's pitch in the big leagues. I keep myself in shape all year round, and these exercises are really very important for me.
Those don't look like exercises to me. Looks like you ought to be in a circus or something.
No, these exercises are not funny. They're really very important, you know. It's just like me going to the bullpen and warming up before a game. I get my arm all loose so I don't hurt myself when I go into the ball game. And this exercise now that I'm doing is to stretch the hamstrings out and the calf, etc. Put your leg out and press your chin down right to your kneecap. And you can feel your muscles stretch out. Feel it, Oz? Yeah, I know, boy. Another exercise you can do, put both legs out in front of you. Put your heels together, and you reach down as far as you can with your hands and grab your ankle. Again, static stretching. We don't bounce. Bouncing is bad for the muscles, and you just gradually stretch them out. How you doing, Sammy? All right?
Yeah, pretty good. It just hurts.
Yeah, it hurts. It's right. You don't want to pull a muscle. That's the main reason for getting loose like this.
Then you can stand up. I stand up, and I'll show you another one that I do. This one for the calf muscles. Put one foot over the other like this.
And go down and stretch. Don't bounce now. Don't bounce. Just go down. It's called a static stretch. Just down for like a count of three, and then back up.
The main thing is to be able to be in shape by the time you do get to spring training, and that means working all year round.
You guys think this is fun, huh? Sitting there taking your pictures, enjoying it.
Good. Cuero.
You got a bunch of old men out here. You can't expect to do anything hard.
I was hoping they wouldn't find me.
Yeah, now that we got them loosened up, Tom, how about giving them a little drill?
Well, John, you know, talking about being a pitcher, you have to talk about the other responsibilities that a pitcher has. After you deliver the ball to home plate, you become a fielder in the infield. You become the fifth infielder. You have the responsibility of the ground balls hit back at you. You have the responsibility of the bunts out in front of the mound. And one of the basic plays that we have is covering first base, and that's a pitcher's responsibility. The ball that's hit to the first baseman deep at first base, and the pitcher has to run over and cover first base and get the ball from the first baseman, or else you're not going to get the runner.
Okay, let's do the drill.
Let's practice. All right, John, why don't you play first? Chicken, you go in. You be the hitter. You can hit the balls, and want the kids all come behind. Come on, Bunch, get behind, and we'll show you how we do this.
Hey, Tom, I kind of like it over here. You don't have to wear a mask.
A mug like yours, you should be wearing a mask. Listen, Bunch, here, look. I'll put this glove over here, and you run right about for that glove, just on the inside of that glove, and that's where you turn and go up the baseline, okay? That'll give you a good direction for you. Hi, Michelle. Let's go. Now, watch out. That's it, that's it. Wiggle a little bit. All right, watch out for that runner now behind you. Here he comes. Up the line, here it comes. Tag the base, he's out. How come you get all the slow runners, Michelle? Do that one. All right, come on, Chicken. Give us a good ground ball. All right, Oz. Make to the glove and up the line. Side, good, perfect.
All right.
Very good.
Nice going.
Very good, Oz. Very good. Perfect. Good, good, good. All right, Sam, break over here. Get over that bag, Sam. Go. Wait. Yeah. Now. You missed the whole thing. Hey, Bunch, sometimes you get a first baseman, you know, that's not too good. So you have to, well, you have to do the best you can. Come on, Chicken. Give us a good ground ball. All right, we're going to do it right, Louie.
Chicken, what are you
chicken,
doing?
What are you doing? Hey, now, wait a minute. Wait a minute, Chicken. Hey, wait a minute here. You're supposed to hit the ball, no? Go get it! Go get it, Louie! Get it, Louie! Get it! Get it! Get it over there, Louie! Go back to first! Get it!
Right. Yeah, you're out!
You're out of there!
You're always in the middle of it, aren't you, Chicken?
The baseball turn after these messages.
Looking in for the sign, Sam flashes. He's into the windup, and here's the pitch. And it's a ground ball to Ozzie. He's up with it. Over tags the bag, and Rick's got it.
Yeah, well, you can't blame us for getting excited. It was June 16th, 1978. Lou Brock led off the ninth inning for the hitless St. Louis Cardinals. George Foster put it away, and Riverfront Stadium was buzzing. Gary Templeton grounded into a force play, and only George Hendricks stood in the way.
So Tom Seaver, now a strike away from his first major league no-hitter. The jack of the pitch. He bounces to first base. Friesen has it. He goes to the bag, and Seaver's got it. Tom Seaver has pitched his first major league no-hitter, and this one belongs to the Reds. Seaver is being mobbed at first base as George Hendrick bounces.
That really had to be a big evening for you. Thrown one hitters before, and you had to have your very best stuff that evening.
Well, John, you know, any pitcher that pitches a no-hitter has to have good stuff. I mean, it's impossible to pitch a no-hitter and not have good stuff. But I think more importantly that night was the concentration that I had about what I was doing on the mound. I was making good pitches, going for a hitter's weakness, going with my strengths, and concentrating.
So how do you concentrate, Todd?
Well, I think one of the best ways you can concentrate or get concentration is to think positively, have a lot of self-confidence. There's just you and the hitter, and even the best hitters in baseball only get hit 3 out of 10 times, you know, if they're 300 hitters. So you've got to figure that the odds are on your side. So concentration really is thinking positively, thinking that you can get the hitter out. And I know that some pitchers do go to extremes to get their concentration.
Well, the jury's out on a few of these Never guys, know. I can tell you that.
Listen, which one of you of the bunch is crazy enough to want to be a pitcher? Everybody's crazy enough to want to be a pitcher for the baseball bunch? Wait a minute. Rick, you were throwing pretty good earlier in the day when you basted the chicken. We'll work with you, all right?
This is no place for a catcher.
Oh, I agree with you, John. Now, what you're trying to do here, and gang behind us, is that you got your right foot over the front of the rubber, and you're trying to get a comfortable position. So here, Rick, why don't you go ahead and throw.
Bring that little exploding fastball of yours up here. I'm ready.
Over the top. Good windup. Boom. All right, you got your elbow down on that one a little bit. Now, remember, when you come to throw the ball, you always want to keep your elbow above the shoulder. You don't want to drop your elbow down in here, because then you start to what's called pushing the ball. You don't want to do that. You want to try and keep your elbow as you deliver the ball. Let me work your body here. Your arm comes back. Look down at John down there. You keep your elbow above the shoulder, and that's an important point. And you can get some leverage, and then you snap the ball, pop it at the top. All right, let me see it again.
Okay.
Good position to start with. Very good. Good. Drop your elbow again now. And one reason you'll be dropping your elbow is that your left leg will be going before you're ready to throw the ball. Try and get yourself together. When you bring your leg in, turn your body like you're doing here. Give yourself time to get set right here. You have to get real comfortable right here. Almost as if I let you go, you'd be almost able to stand just on the one leg. So go ahead. Let's try something. You get to that position and we'll stop and see what happens. Go ahead. Don't throw it. But just go and stop. Ready? Stop right there. Okay. Don't let your leg come out, but that's good position. You see how this is closed and this is closed. Your whole front side is closed going to the mound, going to the home plate. And that's good. All right. Try it again. Good starting position. Feet in the right spot. Good. Ooh, three strikes in a row, huh? And you're working on the inside corner, too. John, he's throwing super, isn't he?
Yeah, great. But now let's see your stuff.
1969 vintage, I guess, huh?
Tom, I don't mind about the broken glove,
but the only thing I can't understand about you pitchers is why you have to throw all those at the same time.
Holy mackerel, look at all those
Daddy,
baseballs.
How many are there in there?
Well, Chick?
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis.
There you are.
Oh, John, you used told me you used to be able to hold seven, though.
Well, all I had was six, Tom.
Chicken, wait a minute. Chicken's up to something. Hold it. Uh-oh, magic man. I'm magic.
Magic. Ah, let's see if that'll fit in there. Takes a little doing, boys and girls.
Seven. All right.
How many is that, Freddy?
15.
All right. Japanese for seven. Right on.
The baseball bunch will return after these messages.
Okay, bunch, let me ask you a question. How do you judge a pitcher's performance?
Oh, that's easy. By the number of games he wins.
No way. The best pitchers are the ones who get the most strikeouts. My dad told me you can tell how good a pitcher is by the number of runs he gives up.
That's right, Kate. An earned run average to a pitcher is like a batting average is to a batter. It's a way of measuring runs allowed per inning pitch. You take the number of earned runs. Times 9, divide by innings pitch.
Why 9?
Well, Michelle, that's the number of innings in a complete game in the major leagues. Let's use an example. Let's say Kate has pitched 18 innings, all right? And let's say she's given up 6 earned runs. Okay?
She'll have more than that. Are you kidding? I would not. It's you, guys.
Okay, but we'll just use
changing these numbers for argument's sake. Let's just use them, okay? 6 times 9 = 54. All right? 54 divide by 18. And that's a 3 with a 0, because that's 3 times 18 is 54, a 3-point ERA. That's very good, Kay.
What's an earned run? Does that mean you have to pay for it?
Damn.
Sam, an earned run is the ones that the batters earn for themselves without the help of a defensive error.
Johnny, what's Tom Seaver's earned run average?
Well, in his best season, it was 1.76, and in his worst, 3.64. So Tom has a 2.60 career average, which is one of the best in the business. But I might add, he's had great catchers throughout his career.
Houston's million-dollar man, Nolan Ryan, had a 3.18 earned run average through 1980. But his forte is strike three. Ron Guidry of the Yankees is a stingy left-hander who's had American League batters searching everywhere for that elusive run. Vida Blue went across the bay from Oakland to San Francisco, but he's still sailing in those strikeouts. Baltimore's Jim Palmer knows that the best way to keep runs off the board is to keep the runners off the bases. And then there's our old friend Tug McGraw of the Phillies. He keeps the hitters guessing, his fielders working, and his fans smiling.
Johnny, does the catcher have an effect on the pitcher's ERA?
Well, I think every pitcher will tell you that a catcher is very important. He calls the signs and really keeps the game under control.
Hey, Johnny, what does the catcher say to the pitcher when he goes out to the mound?
Well, Louie, says an assortment of things. He really kind of relaxes the pitcher and sort of talks about the situation he may be in. He may have to go to second for a double play. And then there's guys that are very tense. He may tell a joke, ask him what he's having for dinner. Sometimes you have to kick him right in the rear, though, to get him to wake up. But you always got to keep the pitcher in concentration.
What about Tom? What do you say to him?
Well, let's show you. Let's say we're in a ninth inning rally and we have a one-run lead.
Oh, brother, what am I doing wrong?
Come on now, give yourself time. You got to get your leg up and give yourself time. You keep rushing everything.
All right.
Come on now.
I'm flying open?
Yeah. You're pulling that left elbow. Now, if you pull that left elbow, you're going to come clear out now.
All right.
Stay back. Give yourself time. You got Garvey coming up. You got double play. Know where you're going. What do you want pitching?
Let's go with hard stuff in to start with. We want to try and get the double play, and if we can't, if we don't get it in there, then we'll try the slider away. Hard stuff in first, slider away. Stay away from the soft stuff.
All right. Got to stay coming up after that, so let's make some good pitches. Come on.
All right.
Oh, how did I do, dugout wizard?
Not bad, Johnny. But let's say that Steve Garvey hits a home run to win the game for the Dodgers. Or let's say one of the baseball bunch gives up a homer. Remember, don't get down. You can't let a mistake bother you, or it will affect your concentration. And then things are only going to get worse. Besides, it's embarrassing watching how silly it looks when you lose your temper.
Mama said there'll be days like this, there'll be days like this. Mama said, Mama said.
None of those tantrums helped change things. Now the message applies to everyone. Pitchers, batters, fielders, and even managers. Don't get down. Sure, you struck out. Well, try to get a hit the next time up. Sure, your team is behind. As Yogi Berra once said, it's not over till it's over. So, bunch, remember, no matter how bleak things may appear to be, keep your chin up. And don't get down.
Pearls of wisdom again from the dugout wizard. Now let's go over some of the wisdom that we picked up today. Chicken, we learned to do jumping jacks in the same spot, didn't we? And also, you pitchers, make sure you get over to cover first base if a grounder's hit to the first baseman.
Yeah, what was that pitcher's lineup again?
Get your foot in a comfortable position across the rubber. keep your body close to home plate before the delivery. And make sure your elbow is above your shoulder.
And that takes a lot of concentration.
That's right. Make sure you concentrate out there or you're lost. Harold, what about earned run average? Do you know how to figure that?
Well, you take the number of earned runs times 9 divided by the innings pitched.
Naturally, I knew you would know that, Harold. Okay, what was the dugout wizard's message?
Don't get down!
All right, why don't we get up and go play some ball?
Yeah!
All right. Yeah. Join the baseball bunch next week when we get more tips from the Major League stars. Like I said, don't get down.